He's pissed.
Take 8.
Not bad.
Yet the strange thing is to have to realize and accept mortality at the young age of 26 years old. It's just one of those things you ignore. The days tick on by and you think they're going to keep coming until the unexpected happens. I did imagine growing up, getting gray and wrinkled, most likely due to the beautiful family I planned on raising with the love of my life. I want that so bad now that it hurts. I'm 27 now and I don't want to go. I love life, I'm happy, and I owe that to my loved ones, but the control is out of my hands. If you can, do a good for humanity and for myself and start donating blood regularly. You'll have me feeling great, as well as it has the added bonus of saving lives. Blood donations, more bags than I can count, have actually helped in keeping me alive for an extra year. A year that I will be forever grateful that I spend with my family, my friends, and my dog. A year that has some of the greatest moments of my life. Today I'm going to be speaking to persuade you to volunteer for the American Red Cross Blood Services Division. I believe the information I'm going to present to be credible, as I've done extensive research on the necessity for blood donations, as well as how the American Red Cross actually distributes this blood. I'm going to begin this presentation by discussing the needs for blood before presenting the solution to fulfill these needs, and then what would happen if we were to volunteer, and what could happen if we were to fail to volunteer. So to begin, I'm going to start off with by discussing the needs for blood. So one of the needs for blood arises with illness. And an example of this can be seen in the narrative that I used to open up this presentation. That actually was not just a fake story that I used to get y'all's attention. That was actually a story of a final post posted by Holly Butcher, a cancer victim who died but was given an extra year of life through blood donations. Her story was reported on by ABC News Australia. Cancer is not the only disease or illness that requires blood transfusions, however, as the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute provides the example of anemia being another illness, with the different types of anemia being iron deficiency, hemolytic, and sickle cell. There are different situations that do require blood transfusions, however, and another situation would be surgeries. Now, in surgeries, blood is needed in order to ensure that the patient does not bleed out while the operation is underway, but it does take quite a bit of blood. As a matter of fact, during a study conducted at the Dr. Abdullah Nakas General Hospital between June 1st, 2014 and December 31st, 2014, there was a recorded amount of 927 requests for blood. That's quite a high amount of blood for just a short span of a few months at just one hospital. And another need for blood arises with severe injuries. According to the American Red Cross Blood Division's website, a single car accident victim can require up to 100 pints of blood. And according to Brookhaven National Laboratories, a severe burn victim will actually require 20 units of platelets in order to recover. Now that's quite a lot of blood. That's a lot to ask for, but there is a solution. And my solution is that we volunteer to donate and volunteer to host blood drives. This solution will fulfill these needs by providing the direct answer to these problems to the American Red Cross, where they can distribute the blood where it's needed the most. To do this efficiently, you should follow these steps. First, you should get tested to see if you yourself can donate blood before contacting your local Red Cross representative to set up a time, location, and date for the blood drive that you are planning to host. Then, you should recruit fellow volunteers to advertise the drive as well as schedule other donors. And on the day of, arrive early to set up your table and then message your scheduled donors. Also, don't forget to message your volunteers to ensure that there is a set rotation of help coming in and out throughout the day and that there are always snacks and refreshments available at your table. Now, this does sound like a lot of work, and it is, but it's all necessary and definitely worth the trouble. This is because if we were to donate, we would literally be saving lives. According to the University of Utah Healthcare webpage, one pint of blood, which is about what they take per donation, can save 3 lives. And not only will you be saving lives, but you're going to be feeling great while doing it. According to a testimony from a peer, a fellow student here at Angelo State University, he stated that after donating blood, he felt great, that he was able to contribute to, if not one, multiple lives that required blood. He said it was basically a sense of grand satisfaction that came full circle when he received a text message from the donation center saying that his blood had been used to save someone's life. Now, if we were to fail to donate, however, it would have some very severe consequences. According to the Brookhaven National Laboratories, there are shortages of blood, and these rise during the summer and winter seasons. And that's pretty severe because somebody's going to need blood every 3 seconds, on top of the fact that Brookhaven also reports that only 5% of an eligible 60% in the U.S. actually donate. Not only that, but blood does expire. According to the American Red Cross Blood Services website, red blood cells must be used within 42 days and platelets must be used within 5. Lastly, according to the World Health Organization, the only way to ensure an adequate supply of safe blood is through unpaid and voluntary donations. So we are the only source for this necessity. So in conclusion, today I've spoken on how, on why blood donations are required and how we ourselves can be the solution to this requirement. I've stated how volunteering will help those in need, but I've also stated how not volunteering will have some very severe consequences. As well as, most importantly, I've stated how volunteering will help everybody in the process, not just one person. So after presenting all of this information, I hope that I've persuaded you to volunteer for the American Red Cross Blood Services Division to donate blood or to host a blood drive. So in conclusion, contribute and save lives. Visit www.redcrossblood.org to schedule an appointment to donate, as well as to contact your local representative for more information on how to host a blood drive. Thank you.